Welcome back to New to Medical Device Sales, a day in the life of a rep. Today, we're going to do it a little different. Today, I actually had a schedule cancel early this morning, and so now my day's pretty open. So I wanted to just show you guys what I do on a day that maybe it's not as busy. You know, a lot of times you guys have seen me when it's really crazy. So I just wanted to show you what I do on a day that's not as busy. So today we're going out. We're going to be following up with doctors. I have signatures of doctors who've said they would like to trial my product, and it just hasn't happened. It's been a couple months. I've reached back out to the surgery scheduler, you know, and I've had a good amount of doctors, over five from this organization, say they would like to. It's just not getting scheduled. So I'm just coming back to learn. We're coming out here to this office to just see if I can set up a time to meet with the physicians again and possibly just help me better understand why they're signing and saying they would like to trial, but they're actually not trialing, and just see what they have to say. So we just got to the first location, so I'm gonna go in, see if we can set a meeting, and we'll see. Right, so just got done with that quick meeting. Just talked with the office manager. So again, here's the reality. I have proof that they signed, you know, I had them sign a request form that they'd like to trial, and the physician that they went and talked to today said she has no recollection of ever signing anything. She doesn't even know who we are, which is funny, you know, like they sign, they know, but it is what it is. So I'm just going to get proof of all the doctors that have signed and send it to this office manager, again, trying to set up another meeting just with the doctors to answer any questions that they may have, why there's any concerns. The one says she doesn't even remember it. But again, it was a couple months ago. So just learning, this is where it's always about, hey, making sure that you're following up and checking in on offices again, because I have about eight physicians through this organization that have all signed, and it's been several months and none of them have done it, which there are cases going on. They're just not using us. And actually this one doctor who said that she has no recollection, she actually had us, she had signed, and she actually had us scheduled last month to use us. And then I took all the equipment there and then got the email 12 hours before the surgery that she wasn't using us, that she was using the competitor still, and that she didn't want to trial us. And so that's for me just trying to understand, you know, what's the hesitation to trial us. So again, that's what we're gonna do. So I got the email of the office manager. We will go get those signed documents and we will send it to her to show that I was not lying, because even when I told them about the surgery scheduler, they're like, no, they don't work here. And I'm like, no, they definitely work inside the organization. And then they told me who it is, and I said, yeah, that is the one surgery scheduler. She sent me off to this surgery scheduler. And she's like, oh, okay. So, you know, just checking in, again, just always following up. So we're gonna go to a couple more offices inside this organization to kind of, again, do the same thing with other doctors who've signed, said they were going to, but haven't done anything. We're just gonna kind of learn more what we can. And then also we're gonna stop at some new offices since we're out in a newer area, and just see if we can set up some lunches. So really today is a lot of following up, but also doing some cold calls to see if we can get some lunches with some new physicians. So here we go. All right, so we just got done at the next office and we were able to set up a lunch with a doctor that was at that office but wasn't there the first time I did a lunch, so that's a win. And then also scheduled a Zoom call meeting with the other doctor who had signed but hasn't used us yet. So again, it was just all following up today, getting things done. But during that time, again, just to show you, you know, I got a call from one of my accounts. They had ordered something. Something's on back order. I have to call customer service, spend 20 minutes on the line with them. So again, it's always just you're doing something and then something else comes up and you got to work on that. So, but successful on these calls, following up with these locations on just getting doctors. And then I am going to, like I said, go home to my office and where I have my sheets that are all signed, I will be forwarding those to the office manager. And then from there, be sending it to the surgery scheduler. And then again, just starting the conversation again of like, hey, these doctors signed, just wanted to check in. And then if they're not putting us, this is what I'm doing, is now going to the doctors and then just being like, hey, you signed, but you're not using us. Just wanted to see if there's any questions or what concerns can I answer for you. Again, a lot of times doctors will just say yes, just to get you out of their hair, and they're like, I don't want you. But again, when a couple of these doctors, they told me how excited they were that they really believed that they're like, oh, this is better technology. So just kind of seeing why it's not getting scheduled. Because again, like I said, it's been several months and we got nothing. So good day with that. Now we are running back to another office. They just wanted to chat real quick. I had to email another doctor who, again, just having conversations with. And then I am going to one of my accounts. They have a PO order for me, and that's just they purchased something. So I'm going to get it from them, go and be able to go put those sales in. So again, just a lot of driving today. I've probably already put on probably close to 100 miles on my car. Probably will end the day with 150 to 200 miles. Just again, Phoenix is big, so you're just driving all over. So again, this is the life. You know, when I'm not in surgeries, it's, hey, drumming up new business of like, hey, here's, instead of doing cold calls and warm calls, I was gonna do a little video on this, but let's just talk about it now, is, you know, when it's a cold call, I could go in and try to go get brand new doctors that I haven't met, that I haven't talked to, and just kind of do that and now start the business of trying to get a lunch and doing that all over. And then just doing what I'm doing now is more of like a warm call. I've already met them. They already have seen my face. But again, a lot of times what happens is these doctors are busy. They forget about you. Again, there are a lot of times if you're not doing it for them, if you're not talking to the surgery scheduler and getting it scheduled for them, they'll forget and they'll just go back to what they've been using. So again, you just have to be proactive in this. Instead of today, I decided to do a couple new doctors. But again, go to more where I already had some relationships, people already knew who I was, and then just follow back up with them. So that's what we've done today. Again, still gonna go stop at a couple offices that are new that I have never been to try to schedule some lunches with some new physicians. But this is really the life of it, as you have people getting out of their car and thinking it's weird that they see me talking on the YouTube. But yeah, that is the life of it. Again, not in surgery. It's never just sitting around doing nothing. You're trying to drum up new business, kind of get new cases going and get into new facilities. So that's what today is about. And also just emailing other accounts and seeing what we can get. But made a couple sales already just by, you know, following up on those emails, getting some sales taken back also just because just working with some customer service as well. So always fun, always a good time, but we're going to go put more miles on the car now. Another successful call. Just went to an office where there's a physician that doesn't use us. There are a couple physicians already that do use us on a regular basis. So just went to follow up to see if I can get a coffee with that doctor who doesn't use us right now. She's not in the office today. So again, just got contact information to follow up for next week. The one thing I do want to just give a little tip about is just what happened in there is a lot of times when you're talking to an office manager or someone in the front staff, they're going to be like, okay, I'll let them know. But you don't have their contact information. There's no talk about follow up. So you have to put them on the spot because they're just trying to push you out of there. They're busy with patients. They're just trying to do their own thing. So for myself, it's like, hey, when would you be back to me? When would I know that you're going to, she's like, I'll just give you a text. And she's like looking at my card. And I was like, okay, when would you follow up with me? By what day? And so then she's like, okay, by Thursday, I'll follow up. And I was like, okay, can I get your information? So I get her contact information to then be like, okay, if I don't hear from you by Thursday next week, I'm going to follow back up with you. So they know it, they expect it. But again, the reason I say that is if I would have just gone in there and she was like, I'll just follow up with you. And you're like, okay, cool, thank you. You walk out, she'll never follow up with you. And she said that, but now you're gonna be like, well, you said you were. So now you just have to put them on the spot. You get their information. And then you also just make them stick to their word. If they're saying they're going to follow up with you, you're going. And then you stick to your word. Okay. If they don't follow up with you by next Thursday, I will be following up with the same office, just seeing about getting a coffee or a lunch or just a meeting scheduled with that physician to just meet with them, introduce myself since she's never got to meet me. So again, that's just a little tip that I thought about in there is, you know, a lot of times it's happened today several times that the front staff, again, you hear gatekeepers, their whole goal is for you not to talk to the doctors because the doctors don't want to talk to reps. They are dealing with patients and have other things in their life going on. So you just have to be able to get creative and be able to get in front of those doctors. And again, just have to call them out. You know, like I had at another facility, they're like, oh, these people are busy. You should stop back on next Tuesday. And I'm like, well, I'm not going to do that because I already know I'll stop back in next Tuesday. She'll be with patients and won't be available. You know, like I'm trying here to set a meeting for 10 minutes. oh, okay. You know, like, because that's what they're always going to do. So that was one thing when I first started, I was the naive guy who was like, oh, okay, sounds great. And I would just do what they said. But now it's like, you actually have to apply some pressure and be like, no, I need to set us on the schedule. So it's in your calendar and my calendar so we can meet. So again, these are just tips that I've learned that, again, that are helping me have more success. Is you just have to be able to, again, they're not even so much pushbacks, but sometimes it can be a little uncomfortable, and you just have to be able to have those conversations and also call them out. You know, I've also had, not today, but other times where they're like, oh, I'm just going to take it. And I told them, I was like, I know you're going to just throw away my card. And they're like, oh, no, I'm not. And I'm like, no, you are. Like, that's what majority, because I've been here 3 times. I've never got a call back. You know, like, you just have to continue to follow up again. And the thing is with sales, it's until they tell you no, until they tell you to stop and like curse at you, you just keep going. Because, you know, maybe they are with a competitor and something bad happens and they talk with the staff and all that good stuff. And then even front staff, you know, if you come in enough, make enough relationships, it can just move forward. So again, today's a lot more slow. That's why I'm giving you more tips. But you know, these are the things. It's about lunchtime now, so I'm going to head back home to cook some lunch. Again, another nice thing of working from, you know, being a medical device, if it's not as crazy, sometimes you have time to go home and cook your own meals. So that's what I'm going to go do. And then I also have a lot of computer work to do. I have to do just put in like opportunities for, you know, the forecasting and just like the business part of it, or more of like kind of the corporate stuff of you got to do some of that. So today I'll be going in and majority of the afternoon knocking that out, as well as putting orders in and doing that. So we will catch you soon. All right. It has been quite the afternoon. So I just had lunch a while ago and then was able to, that doctor that we followed up with, that was with the last one that we did, she actually ended up accepting. So we are going to go meet with her next Thursday, which is good because she's a doctor who does regular cases. So that's great that we'll be able to meet with her. And then again, it's really going to be just going and talking about our product, seeing if she's interested in trialing, which is good because her counterparts already use it. So that will make it a little nicer, a little easier. So again, that's been that. And then the rest of this afternoon, I've literally been on my computer just doing fun stuff. We're dealing with customer service for certain accounts, putting in orders, just following up on, you know, certain back orders, things that's just going on in the business. So it's all the business stuff that you have to do, which you have to have days for as well. And then also, again, doing trainings, things that you got to knock out. I, as you can see, I'm all sweaty. I just went for a run. It is currently 106 in Phoenix. One thing I really like to do to push me, today's kind of my off day from the gym, so I go out on a run. So I went for 35 minutes was my new goal. I usually do like 30, 31, 32. So today I just decided I was going to do 35 and 106. And so the reason I do that, the reason I look forward to it is it's tough. The whole time I'm out there, man, I just want to quit. I just want to, my whole brain tells me stop. Like at the very end, my brain kept saying, no, you did 31 usually. So just do 32 and quit. Just do 33 and quit, you know, like just trying to convince myself to quit. And the reason I say that is because your mind plays tricks on you to where they just want to keep you comfortable. And what I love to do is push the boundaries of, I don't want to be comfortable, because when you are comfortable, that's when you don't perform. That's when you're not growing. And I always want to be growing just in the whole self-growth of, you know, becoming the best version of myself, best salesperson, best person, best, you know, physical shape, all the above. And, you know, that's something I just want to put out to you guys. You know, if you really want to be successful in this career, this industry, or anything you do in life, you always just got to be pushing the envelope. You have to keep getting uncomfortable. You got to be comfortable being uncomfortable, because if you just stay stagnant, that's where you'll get, if you get content and just stagnant, that's where you'll usually get depressed. You won't start seeing results. Again, so you always got to be thinking outside the box and just pushing yourself. Now, again, I don't recommend that anybody goes and runs out in 100 degree plus weather, because you can die. Again, I do this on a regular basis. I'm in shape enough to do it and not and hydrate, and I eat properly, like all that good stuff. But again, the thing I always push for is, you know, you guys just have to know yourself and stay true to you. And that's what I want to end this video with is, you know, you always have to stay true to yourself, no matter what you're doing, no matter where you're going and what you're doing in this interview process. Because even in this interview process, it can be easy to try to become someone you're not.
because you're trying to fit the mold of the company, right? Or fit the mold of the interview you're trying to do. And that's the worst thing you can do, because they're going to see the truth, the real you eventually, even if it's 6 months, 9 months, a year from now, it will come out. So you always have to stay true to yourself, no matter what you're going through, because just understand, even when you guys are going through this interview process, it's not like, not every good, or not every company is a good fit, right? Just because like I go to a doctor doesn't mean they're a good fit for my product. It doesn't mean they are even a prospect, because they might not want my product, right? So again, you just have to understand that you got to stay true to yourself. And again, when you guys are going through this interview process, you know, that people talk about, it's kind of like when you chose college, it's when you choose a significant other. It's got to feel right. Because if you guys try to force something, usually you can feel it. Your gut intuition will tell you. So again, when you guys are going through this, just stay true to yourself. And no matter what anybody says, you know, I say this because I just jumped in the pool and I'm shirtless, right? And there's probably the person who messages me, I get hate for being shirtless. That it, for some reason, it bothers somebody that I'm shirtless. You know, I don't know what the insecurities are there, but they'll rip me. They'll say all these things, and I laugh. And I'll probably get a message from this video, but I laugh because people aren't gonna like you. They're not supposed to like you. You know, like, I'm not everybody's cup of tea. You know, I'm probably a little much for a lot of people, and that's okay. You know, but I have things that are significant to me. And I'm not willing to change for anybody. I don't really care about anybody's opinion. And I'll be honest, that's why I have success. You know, like, I'm not here worrying about what other people think or what other people say. And that's why I'm having success in this territory, because if I did, then every doctor that yelled at me, every nurse and scrub tech that was mean to me, I just quit, right? Like, you can't, you just have to stay true to yourself, know your mission, know your goal, and just continue to stay true. And so, no matter if it's the interview process or once you break in, you know, you just got to stay true to yourself, because whenever you start doing something great, you're going to get hate. You know, and that should be a quote. Oof, that was good. But it's just the reality, you know. So I just want to encourage you guys, you know, keep going, keep pushing, keep being you. Once you break in, this is, again, it's an amazing industry. It allows for autonomy, it allows for freedom. Not every single day is a crazy, crazy day in surgery. But you know, it's going to push you. It's going to drive you. And you got to be somebody who's a self-starter, who's confident, who can roll with the punches. And you're going to have some low days, and you're going to have some high days. And you got to be able to ride that roller coaster, just like when you're trying to break in. So if you guys are trying to break in, you guys can go to the podcast again, or continue to watch these YouTube videos where I just help as many people as I can, give just information, have guests on. Also, you can check out my ebook, newtomedicaldevicesales.com. The link is in the description. Again, where I am just putting everything I did to get 4 job offers from top 30 medical device sale companies. So again, I put in like how I networked, what messages I sent out. I put in my business plan, all the good stuff. So if you guys want to grab that again, especially once you start getting interviews and want to break in, just check that. The link's in the description. But again, I appreciate you guys. I appreciate the support. I appreciate everything you guys do for me. And again, my goal is just to help as many people as I can. So I appreciate you guys. And if the person is watching this that doesn't like I'm shirtless, I really hope they unsubscribe. But if that's not you, subscribe and like the video. Have a good one, you guys.